Welcome to the FDA's History Vault, containing more than 10,000 items from FDA's history. Among the artifacts are tools used by those who carry out the agency's mission, which highlights advances in science and technology, and many of the deceptive and dangerous foods, medicines, and so-called medical products that FDA has helped remove from commerce and that have led to important changes in laws and regulations. This week's episode, a shocking ExerciZe.
Most Americans associate the U.S. Food and Drug Administration with its responsibility to protect the safety and effectiveness of prescription drugs and medical devices. But since 1938, the agency has also had important legal authority to protect American consumers from devices that might, as Congress broadly wrote in the law, affect the structure or any function of the body. What this oversight included was devices marketed as therapeutic, but often had no medical benefits and sometimes were even dangerous. The number of these devices and products skyrocketed after World War II. That's because at the end of the war, there was suddenly a large amount of military surplus electronic parts, such as knobs and dials and meters. When these parts were made available to the civilian population, they served as an inspiration for a generation of inventive gadgeteers. The number of worthless, fraudulent, in some cases harmful medical devices far outnumbered the devices in use in medicine. One of the most notorious of these devices that FDA removed from the market was called the Relaxicizer. Invented in 1938 by electrical engineer William J. Browner, the prototype delivered an electrical impulse, what he called a peak wave. This so-called wave, he claimed, induced a quick and sharp contraction followed by relaxation. Originally sold in beauty salons, but soon enough he created models for both men and women that were sold in suitcases for home use. They all ranged between somewhere between $100 and $400 a piece, so they were quite expensive even then. It was a very complicated device to put on someone. You needed belts, and then you had little electrodes that had to be perfectly fitted and lots of tubing and cords. And finally, you had buttons and dials to adjust the frequency and the strength of each of the electrodes that were there. There were different models. This is obviously the pink one mostly for women, and had a gel attached to it to help with the placing of the electrodes. So this is one that we know was seized in 1964 by inspectors. This was actually a commercial model. It wasn't one of the ones for home use necessarily. The advertising was both intriguing and suggestive. It was a so-called passive ExerciZe machine that the product was most heavily marketed by the company. Its advertisements included testimonials, women and men in provocative poses, and unauthorized endorsements by models and stars. Modern television fans may have seen the Relaxicizer featured in a couple of episodes of the popular series Mad Men, when Don Draper's advertising agency was hired to name the product and create an advertising campaign for it. The combination of ads that were both suggestive on the one hand and promised effortless weight loss on the other resulted in sales that were at least 400,000 or more over a 10-year period. And once it became that popular and received that much outlandish publicity, FDA felt like they had to take action against the product, which they did. During a 5-month trial, at least 40 witnesses testified that they had suffered harm from the machine. And medical experts agreed that the device posed a danger to the general public. In particular, they felt it could cause miscarriages and aggravate pre-existing medical conditions, including epilepsy, hernia, ulcers, and varicose veins. In April 1970, Judge William P. Gray of the U.S. District Court in Los Angeles ruled that the device was dangerous and issued a permanent injunction against its sale. This wasn't the end of it, however. FDA remained concerned about the number of relaxicizers that remained on the market. The agency took the unusual step of issuing a public warning poster that was distributed for display in post offices and other popular venues. The high cost of prosecuting this and other types of fraudulent device cases helped spur passage of the 1976 Medical Device Amendments, sheer quantity of these quack medical devices has dropped off dramatically, obviously, but FDA still is responsible for making sure that fraudulent and dangerous and ineffective medical devices are not on the American market.
The FDA's collection of historical artifacts provides a journey through American history and documents the critical role played by one of the nation's oldest public health agencies in support of its mission to promote and protect American health. We hope you enjoyed your visit.